Dr. Cody Creelman is a beef cattle veterinarian from Alberta, Canada. His veterinarian interests include bovine pathology, large animal surgery, and cow, calf, feedlot production and medicine. Pretty much the same as me. The thing about Cody is he's been showing the gruesome side of his business on his YouTube channel for years. The stuff that honestly you weren't supposed to see. But Cody's been doing it unapologetically for years. And people flock to his YouTube. It has over 46,000 subscribers. Now, before we proceed, I have been told to warn you that this next video is a bit graphic. This is not like the Bambi video that we had before. It's closer to the story of what happened to Bambi's mom, except the bovine version. If you're currently consuming a nice, juicy burger for around a dinner table, well, just know that these cows didn't make it that far.
Hey, this calf had congestive heart failure. There's the nutmeg liver. You see that nice reticular pattern. He also had ascites, so he had a lot of fluid in his abdomen. He had overinflated lungs, so emphysema, and also some mycoplasma pneumonia and an enlarged heart.
What took these cows out? Well, let's learn the info straight from the horse doctor's mouth. Dr. Cody Creelman, welcome. How you doing, buddy?
Very good. How are you?
You're at an airport. You're always traveling.
That's true. I am currently in Palm Springs, and I'm flying to Omaha right now.
Okay. Did you get through security?
Yes, I got through security.
Did you get probed?
No, I am the prober.
Now, Cody, how long have you been doing the YouTube?
I started when I was 31, so 4 years now.
You're only 35?
Yeah.
That's kind of annoying to the rest of us that are in our 40s. Is that your flight?
No, I'm good.
Okay, I don't want you to miss it. I don't want you to be stuck in Palm Springs. Oh, the tragedy that would be.
Yeah, for Omaha.
Now, Cody, you on your YouTube have been showing things that probably the industry said we shouldn't be showing. You know, maybe the posting of the livestock, maybe some more of the gruesome stuff. What was your decision to just go ahead and show all that?
Well, so I guess I started operating fairly early on with the primary tenet of I could show anything I wanted as long as the context was appropriate. Mm-hmm. So if I provided enough background, enough context that I was a beef cattle veterinarian and cattle do get sick, then that would give me permission to be able to share the real transparent story of what happens in animal agriculture.
Did you have any idea that this was going to take off like it has?
No, by no means. I didn't really appreciate the power of the human story, of how people connect with other people's stories. I was just trying to show my life as a beef cattle vet. Mm-hmm.
Well, it is. It's interesting because you have the ability when you're on the YouTube that people feel like that's actually you. You seem very authentic. Is that all just a scam?
Yeah, it's a huge scam.
Now, have you had any backlash from like animal rights groups, anything like that? Because you're showing, you know, the ins and outs, the day-to-days of working with livestock.
Right. So I've gotten the odd comment, but like very, very infrequently, you know, from vegan groups and stuff like that. But I have never been at the brunt of any sort of attack or campaign. I think to an extent I have some, a little bit of a shield in terms of being a veterinarian. So, you know, my job being to help animals. So I feel like that shields me a little bit from that. But honestly, I think some of the greatest negativity is from within the industry, both veterinary medicine and animal agriculture.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. We've seen that again and again when people try to put that out there where people outside of ag can learn from it. Yes, it's farmers and ranchers that are tearing each other down. That's unfortunate. I think that you haven't been bothered by the animal rights people because you have such good hair.
Probably.
Moving on. So you have become kind of synonymous with not only the work, but you show your personal life too. Has that ever bothered you, showing your family in these videos?
No, I know it's a personal decision based off of anybody who shares their life on social media, and I think there's no right or wrong answer. I just really enjoy, you know, my family, and I enjoy sharing my story. So I like sharing that component.
Mm-hmm.
And it has definitely given us far more positives than any sort of negativity. So yeah, you know, my family's a cute little family that has wonderful little adventures, and I like to show that.
How has YouTube changed your life?
It's everything. It's a completely different life compared to the trajectory that I was on. So many different opportunities to travel internationally, different connections, growing my business. Just, it is completely different. It is everything, and it has given me everything that I have.
You've kind of made yourself one of the top agriculture speakers. What do you generally talk about?
I love talking about my Genesis story because of the, you know, the background is very non-traditional for a beef cattle veterinarian to then start telling their story and what sort of impacts and effects that has. So I really like telling the context of that story and then blending in depending on what the audience is. So how does that impact farmers and ranchers? How does that impact other veterinarians? How does that impact veterinary students or the general public? There's different lessons to be learned in you know, my path through this digital storytelling life.
Other veterinarians are going to look at you, and other people that are raising livestock are going to look at you, and they're going to want to try to show their story on YouTube. What advice would you have for them?
Well, the biggest thing that I've seen, I've talked to so many different farmers and veterinarians that have wanted to do this, and really the biggest piece is to just start. Mm-hmm. There's 1,000 reasons not to do it. There's 1,000 scary things. Putting yourself out there, people worried about what they look like or what they sound like, or people are going to judge my veterinary practices or my farming practices. The biggest thing that keeps people from doing it is fear. So there's no right way or wrong way to actually do YouTube. It's just, you got to start.
And you were saying that YouTube's much better than podcast.
No, it's podcasts are going to be the king in a couple years for sure. So you were a renaissance man for seeing that well above the curve.
See, this is where Cody was afraid we were going to cut him off before the interview. It's been fun to watch you. It's been fun to watch this person from Canada that's just loving what he's doing, and then he gets to show it. And I love that people respond to you. You have an ability to talk outside the echo chamber. Is there a secret to that?
I don't know if there's a secret or not. I think I just talk a lot, and some of it goes in the echo chamber and some of it goes out. But I just always operate with the tenet of thinking about providing enough context in whatever I'm doing. And I truly believe in transparency and authenticity. So that's, you know, that's just how I operate.
Okay, where can people find all your social media?
My website, CodyCreelman.com. We'll have all of the links to it, and just type in Cody Creelman in Instagram or YouTube or wherever, and I'll be there.
Yeah, Cody, I wanted to thank you for sending me one of your Palpation Nation sweatshirts. I truly appreciate never getting that gift. Cody, you're doing great job. I appreciate it, and I hope you continue to do this for years to come. You're a great ambassador for agriculture. And I hope you make your flight probe-free. Dr. Cody Creelman, thank you very much.
Thank you.
If you have an interesting or entertaining video or picture, and you think the world should see us, drop us a line, www.sharkfarmer.com. While you're there, check out What the Farm Podcast, and the one that started it all, the Shark Farmer Podcast. Catch me Monday through Friday at Rural Radio Sirius XM channel 147 at 4 p.m. Eastern, 3 Central. And follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.